Hey, big fella.
Oh, it's open. Oh, man.
Can he? They're trying to stop him. He's out. He's out. Oh, my God. Whoa, there's so many of them. All right, well, we're just going to sit back and watch. I'm not going down that. Oh, man. Wreck him. Super Mutant Bob, take him down. Oh, they're shooting the hell out of him. Must feel bad. Oh, he's not even. Yo, pathetic bullets mean nothing to me. I gotta make sure I can spot him. Oh, oh, it'll be that guy. Oh, sucks to be a raider. Oh, the medics were off. Great. How many more are there? There's still one up top. And then there's that one. Oh, nope, he didn't make it. That's pretty nice. Let the super mutant behemoth do all my work for me. You missed a couple. They're still shooting at you, dude. Can you reach him? Oh, man, he can't reach him. Oh, don't come this way. Don't come this way. Poor life choices. Don't want to go down there. I don't think he's going to be able to get this guy. I might have to give him a little backup, but I don't want to give my position away. What is he? Who's he chasing over there? He must have chased one into the corner. Alright, I think it's time to move on. Oh boy. What's happening here? Oh, he went down. Oh, he fell down. That was a poor choice. That was a poor life choice. Oh, there's more back there. Oh, man. I want to go down there and loot so bad, but maybe I'll come back and the behemoth will be moved on. Cuz I don't want to be down there. I don't want to be that guy. Ugh. Oof. He's not getting up after that. All right, it's time to go. It's time to go. Yeah, maybe he'll move on. I got a long way to go. Medics. Pop another one. Especially in my current condition. Not fighting that. Ah. Can live in the wasteland? Gotta be smart. Fighting that thing? Not smart. If I can get my hands on one of those rocket launchers. I keep finding rockets. Launchers can't be that hard. I'd need a better backpack, though. Even have a hope in hell of carrying that. Alright, Super Mutant Bob, good luck. Back out into the wasteland. See how he did. I don't even see him. Ugh, getting the hell out of here. I lost track of a super mutant. Time to go. All right, where are we going? This way? Yeah. I gotta be getting close. I've been walking for a long time. This is day two on this trip. I said it was about a 3-day trip. Well, there's some buildings out there. But I don't know. That might actually be where I'm heading. It's this way, it's down this road. Hup. Hup. You know what I gotta do? I gotta go get Doc Meat. I told him to meet us back at the vault. I wonder if he's there. Hope nothing happened to him. Dad first, Dog Meat later. All right, what do we got? What do we got up here? Oh, Rat Scorpion, shit. Oh, he hunts. These things never give up. That's a bit much, don't you think? I need that armor, that hide-piercing round. All right, well, let's just keep heading on. Oh, those rad scorpions will chase me. Get him out in the open, and then I'll blast him. I know I need a doctor's bag. First, I gotta get across this radioactive swampland. Ugh. Okay, that wasn't a rad scorpion. Security robots of some kind. Oh, yeah, and a rad scorpion. I don't think he sees me anymore, though. Where did that come from? Thought I saw more movement. Security bot. I wonder if I could just avoid him. I mean, I could probably take him down. I do have one more droid popper. I don't really want to waste it. This is where I'm going? Old gas station? Oh, okay. Vault's supposed to be the gas station, huh? That's a military truck. And that's an old tent. I wonder, well, it's a well-made tent. It's still standing. I wonder what's in there. It might be worth it, actually, to pop that droid. First things first, though, find Dad. Let's get inside. Door looks clear. All right, I'm going in. Rad scorpions. Oh, there could be more back here. I hear growling. Could be a rad scorpion. Ha! What the hell? Get out of here. Whoa, mole rats! That's what the growling was. I should have known. Come with me. Okay, looks clear. I still hear mole rats, though. They're coming. It's coming from down here. This hatch. Check out the place before I... Ooh, a gun cabinet. What's in here? A couple of rounds. All right, yeah, I'm hearing mole rats down this pipe area. Or down this this hatch. Well, only one thing I can do, I guess. Ugh. Medics time. Come here, mole rat. There we go. Keep it quiet. Another mole rat. Take him down. Come here. Come here. Ow! Ah, it bit my leg. Ugh. Great, now I'm bleeding. What's in here? Dad? Anybody home? Oh shit. There's a vault here. This was the worst hidden vault ever. It was really easy to find, actually. He's gotta be here. Door still works. Vault Tech built these places to last. If Dad got this far, let's keep the door shut. I want to know if this thing opens and somebody comes in here from behind. Guess I'll just start exploring. Should be able to find my way through a vault pretty quickly. Oh, damn, it's loud. Hello?
Welcome to Vault 112, resident. According to sensors, you have arrived 202.3 years behind schedule. Please redress in your Vault Tech issued vault suit before proceeding. If you have misplaced your suit, I am authorized to distribute a new one. Once dressed, please proceed down the stairs to the main floor so that you may enter your assigned Tranquility Lounger. A Tranquility Lounger is available. Please be seated.
Thanks for the vault suit. Put on the vault suit. You're not gonna let me through, are you, until I put on the suit? Oh, well, hey, a little privacy. Come on. I know you're a robot, but seriously. Alright, are you happy? I'm not taking the hat off.
Please find the nearest Tranquility Lounger and be seated.
And watch those hands, you creepy brain jar thing. Just saying. God, those robots always freak me out. I mean, who puts a brain in a robot? Clinic. Don't want clinic. Tranquility Lane Lounger. Whoa. Some invasion of the body snatchers going on in here. Another one of those robots. Alright, well let me find my way down. Clinic door this way. Oh, might be some medical supplies in here. Okay, don't loot the place. Just find Dad. A little awkward to be running around. Don't wanna have to explain why I become kind of a klepto and started grabbing everything. Well, maybe he'd get it. I mean, he has survived in the wasteland. He knows. It's like the only way you can survive. Weird. What is this place? Well, I guess I'll have a poke around. What? Oh, there's people in there. Wait, Dad? Holy shit! Hey, Dad! Hey! Hey! What? What do you? Why do you look all? All tranced out. Hey, wake up! I found him. God, what do you? Can I open it? Is occupied. No shit, it's occupied. I can see him in there. What are you looking at? Please stand by. Oh God, what do you got in there? Windows 20? Nah, let me get you out of there. Hang on. Hey, Mr. Robot. Hey, hey, what? Okay, whatever. Maybe these computer screens? Unknown subject. Lounger number 23, monitor station, ID unknown. Unverified resident status. Display status. Okay. Everything seems to be not too terrible. His pulse is kinda... Possible program corruption, unable to verify resident's ID, please contact. Okay, display stress level, elevated. Warning, possible program corruption. Oh, okay, so what's stressing him out? Gotta get him out of there. Stress level, nominal. Who's this person, number 37? Stress level, elevated. Yours is elevated. Ugh, very strange, very strange. Damn it, how do I get you out of there? All right, don't worry, I'll figure it out. Maybe if we just shoot it. Or maybe with something bigger. Like, eh? Eh? That's... something tells me that's a terrible plan. God. Explosives? Grenades seem to solve most of my problems. No, that's a bad idea, too. Well. There's people in all of these. How do we get you... Well, let's look around. Let's take a poke around. Figure it out. It's probably like a control room or something. Hello, I'm here to see the Overseer. Ah, oh, Med-X, right. You take the pills and then you don't even realize you pop some Med-X. Hang on a second, Mr. Robot. Med-X. It's okay, everything's fine. Not that you even care. Hello, how are you? Not willing to talk to me? Requires pass key. Open door, I'll check the key. Oh, the terminal's broken. Fantastic. You guys are all no help at all. I want you to know this. Excuse me. Well, shit. I can't blow it open. And I can't... Well, I mean, I could try shooting the blocks off, but God, he's like attached to the thing. Anything can happen. Go back down there. Seems to be it. They said there was one open for me, but I needed my suit, which I think they gave me. Right? Did I? Yeah, I swapped out to my vault, their vault suit, not my vault suit. This is occupied? Yeah, occupied. Occupied? One of these should not be occupied. Ah, here we go. Just climb in here. I can just get it to open. You sound broken. Unoccupied. If I can figure out what's going on here. Not occupied, not occupied. Indeed, I know it's not. What about this one? Occupied? Yeah, occupied. So this one's the one that's not. Here we go, here we go. That one must have been broken. So, do I just get in? Ugh, this is a terrible plan. Let's see what's up here. I hope there's something good on. Hey, hey, hey! You don't have any probes in here, do you? Oh. Whoa. That's weird. What the juice? Whoa. It's like a bad episode of Leave It to Beaver. Huh? Ah! What the? Oh my God, my balls went back up. Oh no, what happened? What is...
Hey, hey. There, sport. Beautiful sport. Day, isn't it?
Say, are you, talking
you
about?
Should go talk to Betty. She's waiting for you over on the playground. Have fun, sport.
I will kick you in the shins. The road to nowhere. I'm in suburbia hell. Ugh. Oh, hey, a dog. Hi. Ark. Good doggy. You just chill. I got a dog that looks just like you. Sorta. Not really sure where he is. Hey, what the hell, man?
Hi there.
Hi.
Oh, someone new to play with. What good luck I have lately. I was just starting to get bored.
You know you're
oh,
in black and white?
We're going to have so much fun.
Now you're not even in Technicolor. Where the hell am I? Oh, what the hell? Wait, I don't live here. What the hell are you talking about?
You do now.
No.
You live here until I say you don't. I know. Why don't we play a game?
Okay. What is going on
We're
here?
Going to play a game now, silly. That's what's going on.
I'll just play along till I can figure out where Dad is and get away out of here. All right, a game, I guess.
I knew you would. It's a really simple game. All you have to do is make Timmy Newsbomb cry.
That's easy. Just kick it. Okay, wait, who is this?
He's the only other kid that lives here besides you.
Kick him in the shit.
He's a big crybaby. You'll see. Make him cry, and then come back here so we can talk some more.
Make him cry. Make him cry. Alright, gotta find Dad, so whatever. Play along. We'll figure this out. So I jumped into the machine, and now I'm in some type of construct. It's pretty obvious. Yeah, lemonade. Maybe this guy can tell me what's up. Hello, Timmy. Oh, this is the guy I'm looking for. I'm supposed to make you cry.
Hi there. I'm Timmy. Wanna play?
I've heard your parents are... Hey man, have you seen my dad?
Your dad?
Old guy?
Nope,
gray beard?
I haven't. Did he get lost?
Yeah. Oh, Betty says I should make you cry.
What? No, she didn't. Did she? I don't like her. She's creepy. And she,
yeah, she gives me the creeps
that isn't
too.
Funny.
What can you tell me about? Wait, none of this is real. It's all some crazy experiment.
What?
Yeah.
You're weird.
You're locked into a box right now with a TV strapped to your brain, and you're calling me weird. Tell me about the neighborhood.
It's okay, I guess. I don't really have nobody to play with, except for Betty, and she's kind of, well, she's mean. Bye-bye.
Now, I gotta make you cry somehow. Sorry, kid.
You're gonna... Ow!
Sorry! It just needed to be done. My bad.
No! No!
There, I made him cry. Where the hell's my dad?
You sure showed him, didn't you?
I suppose it wasn't the most serene. And with that, you win a prize. Your prize is one question and which I will answer to the best of my ability.
How do I get out of here?
An interesting choice. Certainly not what I had anticipated.
Yeah, I'll find my dad on my own. If you're only giving me one answer,
you
leave
when I say so. This place is under my control, and I dictate the terms. If I decide to let you go, you may go.
What else do I have to do around here?
An excellent question. Timmy was easy, and therefore boring. I desire some real entertainment.
What's with your voice?
The Rockwells are the picture of a happy marriage. Change that. Split them up without killing either of them.
If you can do that, I'll have a good laugh and then we'll talk some more.
Pick a voice. Ah. Split up the Rockwells? Ah, shit. I'll have a poke around, see if I can figure this place out. Hi, puppy. Something about that dog.
Hi, Janet.
How are you today?
I was thinking of having a cookout soon since the weather's been so
Janet
wonderful.
Rockwell.
Later.
That's the one I need to talk to. Hey,
good
Janet.
Day to you.
Hello. Let's see what we've got here. But he wants me to break up your marriage. See, if I tell him that, it doesn't seem to matter. They just ignore it. Well, let's see what she says. Betty wants me to break up your marriage.
What? Now that's a ridiculous thing to say. You kids need to find some different games to play.
See, they're not listening. They're like programmed into this. They're probably just constructs. Or unless they're the people inside the pods. God, how long have they been in this place? All right, straight face this. I hate to break it to you, but I saw your husband kissing another woman.
It's that Martha Simpson, isn't it? I knew it. That's it.
Yes, she's making out with the Simpsons.
I've had enough of Roger's lies and bullshit.
That was easy. Creepy garden gnome. Right, so she's gonna go in there and give him a piece of his mind. So if this is where she lives, I'm gonna take a walk around. This is the Rockwells. This is the Simpsons. Hi!
You don't belong here. You're not supposed to be here. It's not real, none of it.
Somebody knows what's going on.
The suffering must end.
Finally, somebody knows what's going on. How do I get out of here?
We're not really here. We're not really talking. It's all made up, make-believe. We're sleeping, dreaming. The dream became a nightmare. It has to end. It just has to. But we're not in charge.
Oh, God. This must have been the plan for the vault. Lock them up into these pods so they can, you know, you can pack more in. They live inside a virtual world, and then once it's time to open up the pods and get out because the world is livable again, you do so. Who are you talking about?
He calls himself Betty now, but he's still the same. He can put on a new face all he likes, but underneath he's still evil. Braun. Bastard thinks because he helped create this place he's God here, but I know he still uses the failsafe terminal. I know it.
Wait, there's a failsafe? What are you talking about? Where is this thing?
It's in the abandoned house. He doesn't want us going in there because he's afraid we might find it. It's the only terminal to the outside, the only way to shut the whole thing down. You've got to
find it. Haven't you guys tried anyways? Why would you stop trying? Seriously, Old abandoned house. Which one is the abandoned house? Well, everybody else has got a picket fence, but this one. Is this the abandoned house? No, it might not matter, actually. Abandoned house. Are you the abandoned house? The Dithers residence. Dithers even says it. Nice car. That's cool looking. Do, do, do. This one doesn't have a name on the mailbox. Anything in the mailbox? No. Seriously? Ugh, even in the virtual world, I got... whatever. It's fine. Let's poke around in here. What the hell? Oh, weird. Ah! Why does it make... And the juice... Oh, the chair just is a chair. Oh, that's good to know. And one of these creepy garden gnomes. That, which plays music when I push buttons. Okay, hey, ugh, Medex. I don't have my Pip-Boy. Oh, I've got little boy arms. This is weird. Okay, okay. Wait a minute. Okay, I get it. I get it, I get it. What's up here? Couldn't there just be a get me the fuck out button? Seriously? Ugh. So weird. This must be it, because there's nothing else in this place. Why would these objects make strange noises? I could play his game forever, but it may not get me out of here. Maybe there's something in the refrigerator. No? 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 How do I have a concussion? Come on. You think these things would have some type of medical software? I thought I broke up their marriage. Okay, it makes a weird secondary sound when you mess with this stuff. So, oh, they're different. We're just playing a tune. Dun, 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 nope. Dun, dun. Dun, nope. Maybe it's, dun, dun. Duh, duh, nope. Do, 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 do. Shit. Am I missing one? I think I'm missing one. Ba-bum-bum-ba. Okay. Do, do. Do. Has to be that one or that one. Unless I've, like, flubbed up something already. Nope. Do, 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 do. I am missing one. Oh, unless it goes back. Da, da, nope. Da, da, da. It's a tune. Oh, oh, I got closer though. I got closer. Bum, bum. Bum, 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 damn it. Dun, 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 dun. Shit, now what? Duh, oh, I got it, I got, oh shit, what the hell? Oh, and I just reached for my weapon. Oh, it's a failsafe. All right, let's see here. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Auxiliary Command Terminal, please contact a supervisor before proceeding. Access Chinese Invasion Program. No, it doesn't matter. Access Version Control. Dr. Braun Entries. Yeah, let's see here. I finally come to the realization that the Lagoon simulation has run its course. I'm tired of the beating sun, the ceaseless pounding of the lagoon's waves upon the shore. I no longer take pleasure in watching Simpson wither away from scurvy or hearing husband screams as he's devoured by the Mako shark. I am quite simply bored. It's time to reset the simulation once again. I haven't been skiing in ages. What is wrong with this guy? Salome. Yesterday, Dither slipped on the Shellet's icy stairs, went airborne, and managed to impale herself on the wrought iron fence. It was spectacular and completely and utterly random. Is there anything more sublime than the bold crimson of flesh-fallen snow? It was almost enough to make the consider a change of scenery, but not quite. God, this guy's sick. 23 years is long enough vacation in the Swiss Alps. I long for something more domestic. And that would bring him to Tranquility Lane. I have surprised myself. I find Tranquility Lane comforting, although distinctly American. It somehow reminds me of the town of my childhood. There's a beautiful irony with this particular simulation as well. The residents here, naturally at home, naturally safe. When I toy with them, when their suburban illusion is suddenly broken, it's that much more satisfying. I do believe we shall all remain here in Tranquility Lane for a very long time. A very long time indeed. Access version controls. Previous version notes. He wiped the other versions. Version controls. Exception granted for pod 001. Manual override. He's updated override memory access individual users. What? Alright. Well, I've got one other option. Access Chinese invasion program. Initiate Chinese invasion failsafe. Oh, here we go, entry for it. There are days I consider finally pulling the plug, as it were, and putting a permanent end to both the simulation and my life. This is the reason I requested installation of General Chase's Chinese invasion program. After all, by disabling the safety protocols, I have ensured that each subject in Vault 112 will physically die if their in-simulation avatars are killed. Real-world death, end of simulation. At least it would have been if not for my own misjudgment. I knew when the simulation first went online that the secondary safeties that established all the vault techs and military personnel would prevent my own real-world demise in the event of a failsafe execution. In the end, I would kill my subjects, save myself. I wouldn't want it any other way, or so I thought. It's true the failsafe would scare the living hell out of every resident in Tranquility Lane and lead to their brutal deaths, but then what about me? I have no ability to disable my own safety from within. My own safely from within the simulation, and any other avatar I would create would be driven by the simulation AI routines, not actually living, thinking human subjects. Where's the fun in tormenting a machine? And so, the release of the real-world subjects is more than deserved. What? They'd be dead, and I'd be left here in Tranquility Lane, alone. That's why he won't unlock the- What? Oh, God. We're initiating the failsafe. Screw him. Review documentation before proceeding. Okay, documentation. Dr. Braun, here is the revised code for the military training program you've expressed interest in. I'm not sure exactly what you want with it, and I again stress that this program was never designed to be run with civilian equipment. Frankly, I don't expect any system you have access to even run it. But if you can run this program, the failsafe off as requested, your real-world test subjects will die if killed in simulation. It goes without saying that officially, I denied your request. General Constantine Chase, U.S. military program. Why'd he give it to him? Purpose, simulate a communist incursion on U.S. soil. New protocols inactive. Disable safety protocols. Override target acquisition. Warning, test subjects will experience real-world termination. Proceed with caution. If I do this, they die. But they've been in hell for so long. Get it done. All right, here we go. Oh man. Run! Yeah, get inside! Not that it'll matter. I'm sorry. It's the only way to free you guys from this hell-pulled madness. Ugh. Don't mind me, fellas. Simulation's over. Guys are all kinds of spazzy. Tough choices that had to be done. Hey, look at door! Now,
do you realize what you've done? You've triggered the failsafe, ruined everything!
Yes, I have.
The subjects will die, and I'll be stuck here in this hell alone!
You ruined everything! Everything!
Well, then you should have given me what I wanted and stopped fucking around. Now I'm calling the shots. It's all over now. Shut up and answer my question.
It is not over. It is not over until I say so. Do you understand me? I.
Uh-huh.
I just want things to go back the way they were.
I came here for my father. Now, where is he?
He's been right here the whole time. And you were too dense to figure it out. the dog, you see.
Man's best friend.
What?
But now you've taken all my friends from me.
So my father's okay?
Yes, I'm
sure
he's fine. No doubt, when you leave the simulation, he'll be waiting for you.
But there's no one waiting for me.
Tell me about the Gek.
The Garden of Eden creation kit. It was for terraforming. For restoring the world after a nuclear disaster. Unstable technology, and ultimately boring. Why remake the old reality when instead you could create any reality you choose?
Which isn't a terrible idea. You twisted it into a hellhole. So I'm free to leave now. I'm gonna go.
Isn't it obvious?
Bird in hell.
You've run the failsafe, disrupted everything. I have no power over you.
There's the
Damn
door.
Right you don't.
Go.
Okay, just out of curiosity, tell me about the Seven Place.
This is my greatest achievement. The best of the many simulations I've run in these 200 years.
I played with the others, but they bored me. This version never grew old. It amused me over and over and over again.
Ah, you're a sick puppy. Who are you and why would you do this? I know you're Dr. Braun.
My name is Stanislaus Braun. I'm a Vault-Tec scientist. I created this simulation for Vault-Tec, but for myself as well. It was my own design, my own perfection. A better reality than any other. Far greater than my work on the Gek.
A mind that made the... I'm leaving.
Run along
the mind
now.
That made the Gek created this place. Oh, look at that. One of them survived. Hey, I'll try to get you out on the outside, but I don't think it'll work. I'm pretty sure you're all screwed. I'm leaving. Whoa. I know Kung Fu. Oh, I've just got gas. That's probably just gas. All right, I'm getting out of this thing. Oh, thank God,
Son,
Manly Beard.
You've saved me.
Dad.
I was afraid I'd be trapped in there forever. It's so good to see you, but what are you doing here?